I'm Dean Cefola, and this is the Azure Academy.
We've got another video in our Windows Virtual Desktop series for you today, and this time we're talking about management through the new Web UI portal. So please take a moment and click on that subscribe button and join us at the Azure Academy, and let us know in the comments below what you're interested in so we can help you out moving forward. So let's jump over to GitHub. So this is the official RDS templates repository. We're going to go to the WBD templates and then to the WBD management UX and then to the deploy folder. So we're going to click on the deploy to Azure button and that'll sign us into the portal. All right, and we're going to run this deployment by selecting a resource group. These first two items here don't change the text at all, otherwise this won't work. So now we need to provide a username and password and a name for our management application. So the username and password, according to the tooltip here, needs to be one that is a contributor on the subscription and also is an owner of the RDS tenant. Okay, and I'll just call my application WBD Web UX and we'll hit purchase. Okay, so that'll take a few seconds to deploy. All right, so that's all finished. Let's go to our resource group. Okay, so we have deployed a app service plan and a app service and a API. So if we go to our app service here and we hit browse, that'll bring us into the UI itself. Now, the UI needs to be registered as an application within Azure Active Directory. So if we go back to Azure AD, to our Enterprise Apps, currently we do not have it registered, but if we go back, here we go, now it's asking to be registered. So let's sign in, and we have to give it the permission and consent on behalf of our organization, and we'll create a new enterprise application with that long name there, and let's hit accept. Now we have to select which tenant group, and you probably only have one at this point, so hit save. Now we're logged into the UI, so let's go back to Azure AD and go back to Enterprise Apps, and there is our new application. Okay, and now under the permissions, you can see that this has permissions on the Windows Virtual Desktop, which is again another enterprise application, and that's where we assign the tenant creator permissions in our first video. So back in the web UI, I've got two tenants at this time, and if I click on this second tenant here, we can then see what host pools I have. I only have one in this particular tenant, and we click on edit. This is where we can make the name, description, and we can update, and that now has updated in our description field here. And then if you click on the host pool, it will then show you what hosts you have. I do not have any at this point in time in this pool, and then you can also go see what app groups there are. So I do not really have anything. This is just the default app group. So let's look at our other tenant. And here are our two session hosts. And if we click on our checkbox here and click edit on one of them, then we can choose to deny any new sessions. Now we could do this in PowerShell as well by setting allow new sessions to false, but you could do it here in the UI. So we'll hit update there. Now this server will no longer accept connections, but our first one will. And then if we look at our app groups, we see we have our default desktop app group, as well as our app group that we created. And if we click on the checkbox for that, we can see which applications are currently hosted. And I've only got three of them here. And then we can choose to publish new apps. So if we hit the publish app from start menu button, that'll scan our systems and find what apps are installed. And there we go. So we can add whatever apps we want from here. So I'm going to add publisher, and I'll also add Visio, and we'll hit publish. And those are now published to our app group. And let's just say that we want to remove PowerPoint, and we'll hit remove app. So there you go. You can now control your app groups from this web interface. And if you still want to do it from a publish path, then you can do that. All you have to do is provide the exact path. For example, something like defrag, and we'll hit publish. And there you go. So either way still works. And let's go to our users here. And this is all the users that are in our app pool. And we could add and remove users from here. So let's remove these three users. There you go, all successfully removed. And let's add Batman back in there. And we'll hit add. And there he is. So now full management over the app groups, adding the users, removing users, applications, etc., can all be done now from the web UI, which is really great. I mean, as much as I do love PowerShell, sometimes, especially if you're new to something, a graphical UI is very helpful for getting to understand what's going on. So just a quick review. So we have our tenant level and we have our multiple tenants that can be present. The management of tenant groups is not yet available in this preview phase, but as we get to general availability, we'll see what happens with that feature. And when we go inside our tenant groups, we then have our host pools. And in this case, this particular tenant has two host pools, one for persistent desktops, one for non-persistent desktops, as well as we can see the different app groups. And when you have non-persistent desktops, you can also have the remote application groups, and then you can host remote application sessions from them, not just desktop sessions. And then inside each of those app groups, we then can set up whatever applications we want and whatever users we want to allow to have access to those groups. And then from our host section, we can manipulate our host to accept or deny new sessions so that we can rotate them through the pool or do patches or maintenance or whatever we need to do on those as we go. So I hope you've enjoyed this quick look at the Windows Virtual Desktop Web Management UI so that you can get a graphical look at what's going on and control your WVD environment. Please click on that subscribe button, and if you thought this video was good, hit that thumbs up, and then don't forget the notification icon so you can be aware of when our new videos come out, which is roughly once a week. Leave us some comments below on things that you'd like to see in the Windows Virtual Desktop Web Management interface and how you plan on using Windows Virtual Desktop as we get closer to general availability. So thanks very much for joining us today. Happy learning.